Welcome to Sand Springs, Oklahoma, where one man's dream to provide a better life for future generations led to the founding of his very own town.
Charles Page was up in Wisconsin. His father died when he was young, and he knew the problems of a mother trying to raise children. So he went off, quit school to raise money. And then he became an entrepreneur, and he traveled. He got as far as the West Coast. He got back to Denver and had been successful in Denver, had a hotel. 1900, he wound up in Tulsa in the oil and gas. In Tulsa, there was this orphanage, always in financial trouble. Charles Page was known for trying to help, but he couldn't get any people to commit long-term. And a Salvation Army captain came to his door, and he knew that he'd be there someday. He had seen him in town, a new young man, and knew he'd come. And he came, and he gave him some money. And he saw him again out later in the day and called up and said, I didn't give you enough, and gave him some more. And then he sent for the young man and said, if I started an orphanage, would you run it? There was a spring over here in the company bottling the water. And Page bought that company and bought the land from that area. And Captain Breeding and his family came in wagons, and they set up in tents, the first home. But it was two people starting something with no major plan, no concept that what they were really doing other than to try to do something good. They built a home, which they outgrew real quick. He wanted to keep families together. They didn't take single children. His idea was to keep families together. Then they built a big dormitory-style building. Page paid the bills of this orphanage. Very quickly, he had to be self-supporting, so this he built first a dairy. First, they had bottled it right here in town. And then they had his own poultry section about 7 miles west of town that raised turkeys. He knew that the springs was not enough water to run a city. So since he bought the turkeys, Shell Creek and dammed it up and brought water into Sand Springs. So at one point, Sand Springs provided its own natural gas, electricity, and water, very pure water. It was a self-sufficient town. So it worked that way up into the 40s and maybe even the early 50s. And then they had the cotton mill, which was really, really big, 1,000 employees at points. And during the World War II, three shifts, full time, and that was my family's connection. We had the cotton mill, the steel mill, the glass factory. The housing of the orphans took on new dimensions. They could live in those houses free, and they could work and have food. And they can go clear up into college. Sand Springs Home had its own hospital. He had built a hospital for them. It was big enough to have a school for nurses that had about a 20-nurse school going on. Page officially adopted each of the children. He hated the word orphans. He said, they're my kids. We're families. Those nurses were around-the-clock help for him in his last couple of days. He died in 1926, shortly after Christmas, and the word was that when he woke, the first thing he said, did my kids have a good Christmas? Oh, I think about it all the time. It's think right was his motto, and I'm a constant speaker of it. Think good, think of doing it, helping people, think right, you know, being more than just yourself. Be aware of what is needed and doing something about it. When I was in the military, my home of record was Sand Springs, Oklahoma. And when I finished, it'll be even Sand Springs, Oklahoma.
The pride that Sand Springs has in its heritage of kindness is the pride we all feel about our state and all of its great untold stories. So join us next week on LoyalTV when we visit Muskogee, Oklahoma to uncover the legend of the real Lone Ranger.